by Mayori Shantin. She's going to explain us the range of congruence for additive manufacturing. Mayori is a chemist with a degree in industrial engineering. She has been working for 12 years at Lafarge Holcim. Expertise on concrete formulation from additive manufacturing and on the extrusion processes associated. Floor is yours. Thank you.
Yeah, thank you. Good morning, everybody. I'm working in the innovation center of the group of LafargeHolcim. And I will discuss with you about the range of concretes for additive manufacturing we have developed in this project. I will explain you the formulation strategy we have developed for the project, we have used for this project. After, I will speak about the characterization we have made on these concretes and which type of concretes we have developed, and then the range of concretes that are existing in LafargeHolcim. The strategy retained for this project is to start with a self-placing mortar, which is very fluid, easy to pump, and to modify it just before the extrusion by the addition of an agent, an additive here, just before the extrusion, to have something like that, something printable, so a stiffened mortar and a firm mortar. What I say by printable is a mortar which is able to support its own weight and to support the weight of the layer above. The mix design strategy for fine-tuned control of the mix of the fluid to stiffened states has been patented. This strategy needs to characterize the mortar at a young age to know if it's printable or not, and to characterize it in the first minutes, we characterize it with a sismometer and after with a compression test. And this permits us to know all about the concrete behavior during the setting time and to know how we can print, in which speed, and how long with this, this mortar. Another test we can do to characterize this mortar is a pull-out test, is to test the influence of the time between the deposition of two layers. And we pour some stiffened concrete in a recipient, and we put the same concrete, a cylinder of the same stiffened concrete on it. And after the setting time, we pull out the cylinder and we measure with the special equipment the strength needed to separate the two layers. And you can see at different times, for example here with an accelerator agent, we can see that if we wait more than 15 minutes, we can have cohesion between the two layers, and it can create a lack of adhesion between the layers. Instead, with a viscosity modifying agent, a second type of additive, we have more time to deposit the second layer. So with this test, we can design the right concrete with depending on the speed we need to have. And for example here, we can use the accelerator for high speed and the VMA for long printings. We have made a 4-point bending test. And as you can see here in longitudinal sample, strength and modulus are globally preserved. Strength and modulus are reduced in transverse directions. This is the type of test we can make on the concrete to characterize them. What about the concrete for the Hincon project? We have considered various axes as insulating concretes, support material, depolluting concretes, and Esther has made some tests on carbon fiber reinforcements, but these materials can't be implemented yet on this version of robot, of X-threatened head. So I have strong focus now on three formulations developed in the project. A formulation based on UHPC concrete, ultra-high performance concrete, C60 and a low-cost material. Here you can see UHPC-based concrete deposited without a robot. So it's a bad result, and we see we need a robot to have some beautiful shapes, but I want to preserve the mystery on what have been printed with this material. First of all, the UHPC concrete, it's for most demanding applications in terms of production rate and shape complexity. There is small particles, so it has a very smooth finish. It measures at least 100 megapascal in compressive strength at 28 days, and has a very high level of early age strength development. This is the most used in the Hincon project. For example, in these graphs, we can see the rise of the shear resistance measured with a seismometer, and you can see that in 30 minutes, we have 40 kilopascals of shear resistance. For the C60 concrete, it's a more ordinary grade of mortar. It has larger particles. It's for any application with moderate aesthetic and performance standards, and the level of compressive strength is around 60 megapascal. And here you can see the same graphics as showed before, and you can see that in 30 minutes the shear resistance is only 16. The third one is a low-cost formulation. It's cheaper and more environmental friendly, but the performance are quite low, around 20 megapascal. And this one was not tested in the Hincon robot because of the larger particles that can break the extrusion head. The same graphic as shown before for the low-cost formulation. So to finish, a range of concretes, these formulations implemented are with the accelerator in this project, but can be developed with a viscosity modifying agent too. This agent permits to have long printings and to separate mechanical properties and structuration. You can decorrelate the both properties and can customize very easy the printing. A range of concretes for additive manufacturing without secondary mixing is also commercially by LafargeHolcim, like in Spain. And all the development of customized mixed is possible for specific applications. You have seen we can characterize and adapt all the mixes depending on what can be what will be printed. Thank you for your attention, and as said by Joseph, if you have any questions, I'm available to answer.